talking about an issue that happened at Trenton Central High School where a transgender student was elected homecoming queen. Now, the issue, the reason I brought it up is that there was a celebratory article written in the Star Ledger's website, nj.com. I always ask this question, you know, if it's okay to celebrate and push one side, why is it not equally okay to discuss the other side? Clearly, when you're talking about children, parents are going through enough of a struggle. And if you've got parents that are advocating one way or the other, I mean, if a transgender person is in a decision-making process, then there are a lot of influences that are going to come in to play. And unfortunately, today, I think you only hear one side. And that, I believe, is dangerous, number one, because I don't think it recognizes the struggle that people go through. I mean, I can't even imagine. You know, some people have trouble choosing what to eat for dinner. Can you imagine that you're struggling with who you are? It's a very serious issue. And I don't think that the struggle gets enough of the conversation. There's a difference between tolerance and celebration. Diane and Jackson, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning, Diane.
Hi, good morning, Bill. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good. Sorry about my voice, because it's, you know, that's something that they can't really take care of when, you know, you get to my age and you go through this whole process. But I heard your discussion and just wanted to help you along, because I've listened to Dennis and Judy making the same kind of discussion and not really quite understanding the basis of the situation. And a little bit nervous talking about it on the phone, because I try to keep this chapter, you know, put back. I went through my I'm 61 years old now. I went through my transition, but, you know, the whole thing around 55 years old, and waited that long because I thought I could outlive it and not, you know, make it known to my family and my children.
Right.
But anyway, wanted to make sure that everybody was aware that this transgender condition happens when you're born. It is not about choice at all. That's really what I want to make clear here.
Yeah.
You don't have a choice. You're born a certain way. You wrestle with it. You don't understand it as a kid. I didn't understand it as a teenager. Mm-hmm. You know, all I knew is that, you know, I was, you know, I had affinity for a certain direction. And I knew that when my body looked correct, the world seemed to be at peace. So for, I think, you know, people that are truly transgendered, you know, as the medical profession recognized finally, that's a medical condition, it's not a mental condition, so that when you're finally, you know, in the right body, so to speak, you know, when the reflection in the mirror looks correct to you, or you're going down the street and the window reflections look correct to you, then you're at peace. So it's really, that's what it's all about. It's a search for peace.
Yeah. Well, and Diane, I appreciate your comments, and I understand at the level that I can understand that people go through struggles. I mean, what you're referring to is something called gender dysphoria, and it's recognized by psychologists as an absolutely a legitimate condition that people go through mentally, where they're confused, they're identifying with something other than what they were born with. I think, though, unfortunately, Diane, sometimes, you know, the way you're describing this, you're talking about a lifetime of struggle where you made choices as a man that you, you know, maybe you would have had a different life had you done this earlier. And right. And so this actually is my point, that I think that it is very superficial for people to be celebratory at a young age with kids. What kids need is guidance from professionals, from spiritual leaders, you know, and this kid's not getting it. That's my point. I feel sorry for the family. You know, the mom talked about, hey, I'm a Christian. I've come to peace with this. I can't even imagine what's going on in that house. And then you open it up by exposing it at this level of the homecoming queen. I think it's a disservice to people who are going through that legitimate struggle. And
I can't agree with you more. I can't agree with you more. It's an extremely personal situation.
Yeah.
And to be broadcasting it, you know, to the public, you know, at that point in someone's life, I think it could be dangerous for the kid. I don't know. Yeah.
So, I think so, too. I think that anybody with gender dysphoria, I mean, I don't know. I'm sure there are articles on it. But, you know, we have a huge suicide rate in this country. We've got a lot of issues with mental illness, and people struggle. And I think this glossing over as if, oh, it's just a choice. Don't worry about it. I'm going to go in the girls' locker room now. It is way, way beyond that. All right, Diane. Well, thank you. Thank you for sharing your story with me on New Jersey 101.5.